winnowing fork is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his granary, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. Now when all the people were baptized, and when Jesus had also been baptized and was praying, the heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in bodily form like a dove. And a voice from heaven came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." The Gospel of the Lord. And then he goes into the wilderness. me strength, insight, and courage to discern. We also celebrate today the Reverend Martin Luther King Jr. and his work that started with the gospel, how to reach out, all sorts of rights, including voting rights, that we continue to need to persist in. But that discernment started with the gospel in community. And I highlight this particularly right now for St. Paul's, both us as individuals and as a congregation. This time of discernment starts with prayer. Because just as those people who were filled with expectation had an idea in their mind of what they were going to get, God's imagination far exceeded their expectations. Maybe wasn't exactly what they were expecting. A carpenter's son? Born in a stable? But in discernment, and with the Holy Spirit gathered in community, God is doing far more than we know or can expect. Our baptismal vow to one another, and I remind us of this often, is will you support these persons in their life in Christ? Support these persons by showing up for one another, whether it's in person or needing to be at a distance, but still connected by the Holy Spirit. But God is doing far more than we know and doesn't invite us into the easeful, but says, I will be with you, I will love you, and I will honor you. You are precious to me. We are God's treasure, and may we center ourselves in God in this season that starts with the word Epiphany, but continues with expectation and the unfolding of God's graces and mighty works. Amen. Amen. Gracious